This is UNICEF television.
Before dawn, in a one-room shack in Kibera Township, Kenya, 12-year-old Maureen Akinyi is ready long before her cousins. Entrusted with the keys to the classroom, she first makes sure that all of her homework is finished long before school starts.
I used to see my friends going to school and coming back, and they used to stay at home helping my aunt.
When her parents died of AIDS, Maureen left school. Now she is riding the wave of a revolution in Kenya, free primary schooling.
I was happy to join them too in school to learn.
The boys are sleeping.
Kenya's vast education experiment has hit the ground running. For Maureen, it was a second chance. Like the 500 other orphans here, she cannot afford any schooling. Many can't even afford the $5 a year for food at school, so they get it free. They can't even buy uniforms and depend on hand-me-downs from the older students. The deluge of students has stretched school to the maximum. Here alone, enrollment doubled, and teachers are sometimes ill-equipped to face the surge of students. At her youth club, Maureen discusses a disease that left her without parents. Exams are over now. She came in the top five. But the government doesn't offer full scholarships for high school. If nothing changes for Maureen, her dreams of becoming a lawyer or accountant won't be possible. And she is not alone.
I can request the government to sponsor them and also to get a school for orphans or a place where they can stay, because mostly for girls, when their parents have died, they leave school and get engaged in different things.
But for now though, Maureen is just happy to be at school, happy to have a chance at an education. This is David McKenzie reporting for UNICEF, Unite for Children.